bound. What is the meaning of wonderbound? So in Mahabharata, there is a wonderbound that is called Akshaya Patra. So in that Akshaya Patra, so this one is given by Lord Krishna to Draupadi. Okay, when they are in forest, they are exiled from exiled to the forest. Lord Krishna, to help them, he has given Akshaya Patra to the Pandavas, especially for Draupadi. So we are already discussed about that. Now we will discuss the wonder ground in the continuation part. Okay, wonder ground. So let us start. It's a very interesting topic actually. So let us start. The old couple Philemon and Baucis lived in a hut on a mound. They worked hard in their farm and were only able to get as much as food they needed. And they were so kind that they would never let any stranger who came to their doors go without food. They welcomed the guest with joy and shared their own meal. One evening, they finished their supper and sat at the door. Suddenly, they heard the barking of dogs and shouting of boys in the village. Soon the noise grew louder. Philemon saw two strangers at whom the village boys hooted and the dogs barked. Philemon said to his wife, "Look at these boys. They ill-treat the poor strangers. I shall go and bring them. You go and see if there is any food to give them." Philemon went down to meet the ragged newcomers. He drove back the dogs and said, "Welcome, strangers." He took them into his poor cottage and made them sit at the table, and they looked very tired. Okay, so here there is a story of two couple. They are very kind-hearted. When someone came into their house, they feed the food and they help the strangers very much. Okay, so they are kind-hearted and they are very helping nature. They have the helping nature. Okay. If someone or if strangers came into their house without food, they want them to go out of the house. This is the thing happened in this lesson. So the old couple, they are old couple. Okay. Philemon and Baucis lived in a hut on a mound. Mound means raised ground. Okay.
They are not like others. So what others
They grow much and much, much more food, much more things. They earn much more money like that. But these two couples are not like that. Understand? So, they grow what they wanted in their life. Okay? And they were so kind that they would never let any stranger come who came to their doors go without food. And these two couple, so they earn and they grow so what they wanted, okay, very less food they grow and they want very less. For both old couple, how much food they want? Only little, okay. So that much only they got in the house. And if someone or if some other person came into their house, so they used to feed them, they used to give food, without empty hand. So they look after the strangers or guests who came to their house. So and they don't want them to go with an empty hand. Okay, they wanted to be their guest with a full, full stomach. Understand? They welcome the guests with joy and share their own meal with them. They very heartily welcome the guest. Okay, these two couple, so Philemon and Baucis, so they welcomed the guest warmly. They welcome and very heartily they welcome and so with joy and happiness. So they used to share their meal with the guests. Understand? One evening, they finished their supper and sat at the door. Suddenly, they heard the barking of dogs and shouting of boys in the village. One evening, one particular evening. So what they following is, so they earn very less. Okay. So whatever it is, less or more, only how much they wanted, they only kept what they wanted food. Okay, and they don't want to go the guests with the empty stomach. Okay, they used to feed them with joy and happiness. So one particular evening, so after their supper. Okay, after they suffer, so they are sitting in the corner, means sitting in the door. Okay, they used to sat in front of the door. Suddenly, they heard the barking of dogs and shouting of boys in the village. Suddenly, when they are sitting in the door side, they suddenly heard the barking of the dog. So what? So we can call the dogs. When they shout, and we can call it as barking. Okay, bugulthittu. So they are barking, and village boys are shouting. Suddenly, these two couple, Philemon and Baucis, heard the voice of the dogs as well as the boys of the village. Soon the noise grew louder. So very soon, so the noise. That is grim more and more. Okay, something has happened so that the dogs and the villagers, they are shouting. Understand? So both Philemon and Baucis, so they are very curious to know what happened to the village or what happened to the dogs. So the noise grew louder. Philemon saw two strangers at whom the village boys hooted and the dogs barked. Philemon saw the two strangers. Philemon, so he's the man, he saw the two strangers. So, for example, so you can just imagine. So, we have everyone, almost everyone, not 90% of people have their pet as dogs. Okay, in their home. In your home, so dog, if they barking, they very shouting. Okay, so they are just shouted because they haven't seen those people in the previous, so that they are shouting and they are barking like that. Soon the noise grew up. Okay, whom the village boys hooted and dogs barked. Hooted means shouted.
Guests are also, I think they are also
very kind hearted, so that don't worry lady, so don't worry good lady. So said one of the guests, two guests are there, two strangers are there. One of the guests said like that, said to bosses, don't worry good lady, so all is well, so all will be well. Your kindness makes this drink a feast to us. We are pleased with your hospitality, your kindness. So every so the dogs are barking and the villagers are shouting. So on that situation, these bosses and Philemon, so they welcomed those strangers into their house, and they give the milk, a bowl of milk to them. So this incident makes them so very happy, make the guest felt very happy. And then we are pleased with your hospitality means friendly reception of the guests. Okay, treat the strangers like the friendly. That is called hospitality. Okay, so they are pleased, they are blessed with the hospitality. Who are blessed with the hospitality? The guests, the two strangers are blessed with the hospitality of the two old couple, that is Philemon and Baucis. Baucis poured the milk from the bowl into two cups and placed them before the guest. Baucis, she poured the milk, and so she shared the milk into two cups and served to the guests. They drank the milk, and later one of them asked for some more. Both are drank the milk, but so one of the guests of the two strangers, he asked for more milk. Bosses in confusion said, sorry my dear guest. So bosses now, she is helpless. She wanted to give something, but she don't have anything. Understand? Now one of the guests, he wanted some more milk, and with hesitantly the bosses said, sorry sir, sorry my dear guest. How she is like kind hearted, how innocent she is. Okay, if this one is happened to us, what will we do? So we don't have anything, we can go to the next door. We said like that. But these two couple, so they gave as much as possible. They will give. Okay. But still, both the couple did not, they have failed to fulfill the needs of the two guests. Okay. There is hardly a drop left in this bowl. Why? Cried the guest taking the bowl. There is milk in this bowl as much as we want. So seeing, he filled not only his cup but also his friend's. Bosses was astonished as the guest filled their cups again from the bowl. She could hardly believe her eyes. They are not ordinary men, whispered Bosses to her husband. Yes, he replied, they must be angels from heaven come to bless us. Yes. So now the bowl is empty. A drop of milk is there on the bowl. But still, these two strangers, okay, so they said that, so we have, and the bowl has the as much as milk we want. And both of share the milk, and they drink, and they fully store, their stomach was full. Understand? Now this was unbelievable. There is no milk on the bowl, but still these two guests made that bowl to fill with the milk. So it is very it is unbelievable to the old couple, and they whispered themselves that, so So these two people are not as human beings. They are angels. They came here for blessing us. So we can call it as. So those are maybe the gods. So if so through this story, I wanted to tell you that. So be kind and be helpful to others. Because one day the God surely help you one or the other hand. So that want your guest with the empty hands. So whatever it is, wherever it is, and whoever they are. So if they came your house with the empty hands, you should feed them. You should give food. Them. So this is the one thing we learned from this lesson. Okay. Next, good mother, said the guest, we thank you for your kindness. May your bowl be full of milk always. So that the two guests are blessing to the two couple. So good mother. So they called that bosses as mother. Because she gave food to them. So that they said like that. We thank you for your kindness. Very kind hearted, very innocent. So that we are very thankful to you. And may your bowl be full of milk. So both guests, both strangers blessed them with with all the respect. Understand? All the respect, with all the things they are blessed. What they blessed? May your bowl always be filled with milk. They blessed like that. Then they went to bed. Feminine bosses could hardly sleep because of the wonder that the strangers had worked with the bowl. Okay. Then they went. So they went to bed. Philemon and bosses could hardly sleep. It's very difficult to sleep because this is like miracle for them. Okay. So when there is empty bowl they have, but still, so they can see the full of milk. So they are wondered and they are sleepless night. That was the sleepless night for the both couple because of this stranger's miracle. Understand? The guest arose early next morning and got ready to go. Philemon and bosses walked out with them for a short distance. Good Philemon and bosses, said one of the guests, we are God's messengers. We are much pleased with your kindness. Ask for anything you like. You shall have it. So in the next morning, so the guests are arose. They woke up and they are ready to go to their they don't have any particular house. They are ready to go to their way. So these bosses and Philemon, so they go for a distance to drop them, and when they are walking. Guests said to Philemon and the bosses that we are not strangers, we are not guests, we are the messengers of the God. So we are here to help you. So that both are very kind-hearted. So that I am blessed to fill the bowl. Understand? They are blessed also, and they said that. So they are very thankful to their kindness, and you can ask what you wanted and we will give you. So those two messengers of the God, so they asked like that. The old couple looked at each other. After a moment, Philemon said, good angels, we wish to die together. So how innocent those two couples. So if happens to us, if it is happens to us, what will we ask? So we want money, we want education, whatever it is, so we will ask. But these two couple, they asked. So the old couple looked each other and asked. After a moment, Philemon said, so he said and he offered that he wanted to die together. So both are wanted to die together. Okay, this is the thing they asked to the God, God's messenger. So very heartfelt story it is. Be it so, replied the angels. There is a home. Live in it as long as you desire and come to heaven together. So they show a house, and this is your house. You can live here. And so whatever it is, so when you are fulfilled all your desires, all your wants, afterwards come together in our heaven and together. Okay, he said like that. The messengers of the God said like that. Old Philemon and bosses were astonished to see their poor cottage turned into a grand mansion. Grand mansion means a built beautiful house or a palace. So, these two couple, they're very happy. And they are wondered, astonished means converted into a beautiful palace. Understand? So both are happy, and when they turned around to thank the angels, they saw nobody there. When they saw their house, a small cottage into the palace, they are wondered, they are astonished, they felt very happy. So afterwards they turned to thank those two angels. There is nobody in the place. They are already went away. They humbled prayed to God and lived in their mansion, doing good to everyone. Okay, so with humble, with respect, with all the love, they went to their palace and lived happily ever after and doing with good things to everyone. This is the story, wonderful. So after reading this lesson, so we should be good. So be good to everyone, not a single person, not a this person, not that person. We should do good to everyone. Okay. So we are always thankful to the person who helped us, and so we are always thankful to who make us to do good things. Okay, whatever it is, if someone came if someone needs our help, we should always give our helping hands to them. Okay, so this is the one lesson, and this is the moral story. And one more thing is, when someone came to your house, so we should give anything to them. So whatever it is a money, it is a food, whatever it is, we should give them, because everyone asked anything to not everyone. Okay, so everyone, they don't want to ask anything. Okay, so hinge yaar kelthara, so nobody asks for the help, for whether it is a food, whether it is a cloth, whether it is a money. Nobody wanted to give. Nobody wanted to ask for anything. But if someone asked, so they are helpless. They are helpless in their life. They are failed. So that we should give them. we should help them. Okay, so this is the story of the two old couple. So Philemon and Baucis. So okay, hope you understand, and thank you.